so much for spending your Sunday afternoon a week and a half before Christmas with us. We hope you truly enjoy our performances this afternoon of all of the wonderful selections that we're doing. It's been an honor and a privilege to be with this orchestra. It's a little bit emotional for me. If you guys had not read my note in the program, now would not be the time to do that. You might want to wait just a little while. We have a lot in store for you this afternoon. So if you would, the next selection we're doing is the Nutcracker Suite. So we have several movements. We'd appreciate it if you would hold your applause until we're totally finished with all the movements. Thank you.
Thank you. something. She's waiting. Are they in the sound booth? Hello? Okay, I'll just talk loud until something changes.
Oh, is it on? Oh, goodness. And I won't yell, I promise. So I'm going to tell something, I'll share something with you guys that I don't think I have shared with the orchestra. And guys, I apologize for that very last minute. That was my fault. My mother loved waltzes. They were her favorite. Brahms waltzes. Brahms waltzes were absolutely her most favorite. And the Nutcracker Suite is super special to me because when I was a wee little girl, and my sister and I were trying really hard to figure out how old we were. I know I was in elementary school. I might have been third grade, maybe. And somebody gave my mom tickets for the three of us to go to see the Nutcracker at the Kennedy Center, the whole ballet, the pit orchestra, the whole yards, everything. And I sat there where there were balcony seats. They were the best seats I thought ever because I could just like, I could see the cellos, I could see everything. You could hear the toes, shoes on the floor, the ballerinas were just beautiful. The story was so magnificent. And it's one of my earliest memories. I have an earlier one, but that's probably the one that's the most vivid with my mom. And so the Nutcracker Suite has a sentimental, special spot for me in my heart. And then, of course, the waltzes being her favorite ever. So that was hard for me to get through that last one, and they did a beautiful job. So thank you, orchestra, again. Thank you for doing that. A little bit about this arrangement, actually. I did not make any notes in the program about this, but there's a gentleman, the arranger, and David Brindrett, and he's actually in England. David did an arrangement of this that I found online several years back, and we performed it, we played it, not like tonight, but this was good. And I reached out to him. He did one other one, and I reached out and I said, have you thought about finishing the Nutcracker Suite? And he went, oh, I got so much going on. He's actually a bassist, and he's in England, doing the whole living the dream of a musician. Lo and behold, midsummer, I get an email. Christine, I hope these will do. And he sent me all the arrangements, the rest of the score. He finished. So it is a great honor to actually premiere as a work his stuff tonight for the first time. And we will be sending him a recording of that. So thank you for listening. Now we're going to move on to the next number, which is actually the only traditional Christmas carol that we are going to play for you today, Pas de Pan. It is actually a French carol. It was composed or written down, if you will, about 1720. It was adapted into English later on. And notes that I was able to find, you might know some of the words. It says, Willie, take your little drum. It's kind of reminiscent of the drummer, Little Drummer Boy. So if you're not familiar with this carol, you might see a similarity to the two. So this is going to be our rendition of Pas de Pan.
Thank you.
set that we're going to do for our next number, so if you'll excuse us while we do a little bit of that shuffling. And then we will let Elijah Cove, Matt Wagner, Cameron Toller, and Abigail Wood perform for you for their rendition, their arrangement, well, it's not their arrangement, but an arrangement of Mary, Did You Know? before our intermission, and we would like to invite you to actually enjoy the intermission. On behalf of the families of the members of the BCE, there have been refreshments provided, so out in the lobby during intermission, you can find the restrooms if you need and enjoy a little snack. We will probably come out and say hello and whatever, and we've got about 15 minutes, enjoy some social time. It is the season anyway. So after this song, we'll see you back after intermission.
Thank you.
second half is a little lighter, as you can see through the programs, some really wonderful popular kind of secular Christmas tunes. So we're just going to kind of go on with the show, as they say, now that we've broken the string, been out of tune, misplaced the baton. I think we've done everything we needed to do and we can carry on. So we'll see you at the end.
Thank you.
So, here we are at the end of our program. You guys may have a seat. Aren't they amazing? Cellos, all of them. So, there's a little bit in the program about the VCE. Just a little blurb, a little touch on that. Just want to make sure you guys know what you're listening to and what you're hearing. So you're hearing all of our firsts, our high notes coming from this section right here. Then we have the harder part, actually, is the second, like a second violin. And they're in the middle over here. Go violas in the middle, the cello threes.
And carrying up the bass line is the cello fours. Aren't they magnificent?
We currently, I think, maybe wrong with this, but I think we are at 8th grade. Oh my goodness. He's asleep over here. Okay, so I think currently we have 8th grade students that are in the 8th grade, all the way up to adults. This is an orchestra that is open to the community, all ages, all levels of ability, from 1 year solid experience in playing and performing, so you have to know certain skill set to be able to be on stage. Some of the pieces we performed for you were 5 parts, and some have a little bit more to what's going on. So I just wanted you to know again what you were listening to, what you were hearing. You're hearing an orchestra of cellos, and they have done a fantastic job of sounding like an orchestra. So before I welcome to the stage, or I should welcome to the stage, we have a fifth section for our last piece, and we're going to add some more percussion for our last piece, because, you know, you see the title, it wouldn't be the same without a certain stuff. And we've got our festive gear on. So on behalf of the Virginia Cello Ensembles, all of the members, their families, all of you, to all of you, we just thank you so much for being here. Thank you for attending our performance this afternoon. Oh, and before I forget, I think there was still some refreshments, so thank you again for all of those who did the donation. The idea is not to take much home or anything home, so please, on your way out, feel free to, socialize a little bit more. It's 'tis the season, and grab another snack or something on the way out the door, so that we don't have to worry about taking anything home. So, have I forgotten anything at all? No? Are we good? Oh my gosh, where is he? He's somewhere. Michael Knowles. Okay, in the program, the arranger who has dedicated the next piece to us is in the audience. So we actually got to hear it for the first time. Oh my goodness, he sleeps super in the way back. So we want to thank Michael for his phenomenal arrangement of Sleigh Ride, to which he dedicated to the Virginia Cello Ensembles. If you have a favorite cellist in our orchestra, you have heard their part probably an awful lot at home. Now you get to hear what it sounds like all together. Having said that, we are being rotated on the Hometown Holiday Spotlight with the 95.9 radio station, Super Classic Hits Radio. They do that, if you're familiar with that. We are at Christmas music 24/7, all the way up and through Christmas Day. And on the 10 minutes of every hour, certain times during the day, they feature a local ensemble or group, and we are in that rotation. So you can check their website out for the next time and actually hear us on the radio, which is pretty trip. It's pretty cool. Thank you again, just for everything. There's a list in the program. I hope I have not left anybody out. Fredericksburg Academy is wonderful. Our performance venue is just amazing, and we still fit on the stage. UMW for use of equipment and their rehearsal space, because that is awesome that we have that available to us as we need it throughout the season. We had programs and website and social media, and the list goes on. More importantly, we want to thank you again for being here, for supporting us, and for being a part of our Christmas season. So on behalf of the Virginia Cello Ensembles, we would like to wish you all a very Merry Christmas. And then, oh, what? House lights! House lights! There's a disturbance! Where are the house lights?
Thank you.
Scott Smith is in the house, over here. So while the rest of you make your way to go get some more treats, we're gonna take our way to get off the stage, and please feel free to go and visit Santa. I know there's quite a few hanging out in the audience, and get your picture taken. Merry Christmas.